Tabazani, Tabazani. I am Gogo Noma. Welcome to Learning with Noma, your home of comprehensive learning and healing. If you're new to the classroom, just remember we are changing our lives one lesson at a time. In today's lesson, I am going to be talking about Ditaola, the bones, Inkolo, Amathambo, the tools that we use as Abangoma, as Sangomas, in order for us to do consultations in divination to see what is wrong with you, in order for us to help diagnose and plan treatment for all the spiritual disease that are manifesting in your life as physical ailments and as life problems. Let's hear more about Ditaola. Tabazani, please do remember that in this classroom, everything that I share is purely from my own lived experiences, everything that I do and Ndumbeni as I practice, and all the teachings that I've learned over the years from all the mentors that I've received in my spiritual journey. It is in no way the only truth, but it is part of the truth. So we usually say that in spirit, you take what resonates with you and you also share your own story so that we understand. The objective in this classroom is to learn together and to grow together. So I would love to hear from you about Ditaola in the comment section below. All right, so Ditaola, as I define them in Ndumbeni, these are the tools that I'm given by my ancestors to help in the diagnosing and in the treatment of my patients as they come with spiritual disease that I need to help, because most of the spiritual diseases, you're going to find that they manifest in physical ailments or life problems. So I use Ditaola to do the diagnosing. It is sort of like your doctor with a stethoscope, your nurse with a stethoscope, your blood pressure machine. I use these tools to help in the diagnosing of the ailments. The tools help me also in terms of being different in my practice. When it comes to the physical healing and the spiritual healing, in that when you come in Ndumbeni through Ditaola, you do not need to tell me what is wrong, but I then invite abantu abadala and I throw the bones and we are able to diagnose spiritually what is a disease with you. So you do not do history taking, you do not give history, rather I do not do history taking, but I throw the bones and I invite your ancestors to come through and tell us what is wrong with you or what is a disease, starting it at a spiritual level and understanding how it is currently manifesting in your life physically. So Ditaola are those tools that we use. They are referred to in many different ways. Others will call them bones, masapo, adingaka, inkolo, amathambo. You've got different languages calling it in different ways. But Ditaola is tools that we use for divination that help us with the diagnosing and the treating of patients when they come with spiritual disease that manifest as physical ailments or life problems. And what happens with Ditaola also, you will find that different practices have different tools or bones in their backs. Okay, let me start with the bag itself. Iskhwama, as we would refer to it. Iskhwama will be the bag in which Ditaola tsa hao is being carried in. So this bag is known as Iskhwama, and Iskhwama directly translated is a bag. The bag can be made of animal skin, which can be a cow, a goat, or any animal skin which will be chosen by your ancestors. Other people you're going to find that is actually made of a cloth or a certain material, whichever way that your ancestors or whichever that the ancestors would have chosen, that is what Iskhwama will be. In definition, Tokoza, we can just say that Iskhwama is the bag in which the tools or the bones are carried in. And I'm very careful and also very conscious in just saying that they are bones, because Ditaola is more than bones. Inside Iskhwama, the bag that holds Ditaola tsa hao, you are going to find that it is more than just bones, because you will find that we also carry shells, we are also going to find that in the very same bag, you are going to find things like indoro for many different people. So these are basically tools that you will use for divination, not just the bones of animals that you're gonna find in Tolweni ka Gogo or Akamkulu. And then how we use these bones, or how we use Ditaola Zarona, I'm gonna stick to Ditaola because when it comes to bones, it's just like I'm limiting it. How we use Ditaola Zarona is also different, because our skhwamas are not the same. What you find in my skhwama, you will not find in another Gogo skhwama. We also include crystal stones. We also include money. We can include cutlery in some of the other skhwamas. So there's different reasons for different people. Others even have the bones like myself with beads around them. Others you're gonna find that they don't have beads at all. It's just the bone as it is. But Ugogo Umkulu will know what the bone will mean, or what that particular Ntlolo would then mean to them when they throw their bones all together combined, or Ditaola tsa hae di kopane. How we then use Ntlolo, let me start by saying to you, where would you then find Ntlolo as a healer? In different practices, it's different, and for different journeys or different people, it is also different. One, you might find ukuthi we always talk about umphathi wesikhwama or umnikazi wesikhwama, the one who is bringing the skhwama to you as a gifted person. And this can be your grandfather, it can be your grandmother, your great great, or somebody that you knew in the family, somebody that you didn't know. And this is the person who bears the gift of Ntlolo, the one who will be there to help you as you throw the bones, the spirit that will be guiding you in terms of reading the bones. You might also find that in some families, because it has been kept safe and sacred, that the skhwama in itself is still available, and therefore it's just passed on from one generation to the next. But in other instances, you find that one will have iskhwama sasempandeni, meaning that it will be the skhwama that is put together from the institute in which you had trained at or in which you had practiced in, and it will be the same for amathwasa wonke in that place, and this is where you will get your skhwama. In other instances, you find that you dream about these things, or you even start collecting them before you even know what your journey is all about. But in all essence, iskhwama or Ditaola tsa hao, it is what you are given by your ancestors to help you in divination, and this can be given through different methods, as I have mentioned just now. And then the other thing is, when it comes to Ditaola, when we come and do Mbeni, you will find that different gogos use different methods. Traditionally, you would take your bag of Ntlolo and it will be shaken, and then it will be given to the client or the patient, and they will need to breathe into it or blow air into it. But due to COVID-19 and also the development of us as healers conducting consultations online, we have come to find, or we have come to discover rather, alternative ways in which spirit can be summoned. So it doesn't really need for one to blow into the bag. But in Ndumbas, where you find that people are still blowing into the bag, you will find that abogogo nabomkhulu are using impepho to smudge the bag before and or after the consultation, just to make sure that there is that disinfecting of the bag between patients. So what will usually happen when you get Ndumbeni, ugogo umkhulu will firstly ask for your names, your paternal surname and your maternal surname, marital surname if it is applicable, and this will then be used Ntlolweni. As you blow, you will say your names if you're blowing, and different Ndumbas, please understand that there's different procedures that are followed. For an example, in my practice, you will then send the names beforehand, and I'm the one who's going to call them when I shaya amatambo, or when I throw the bones. But in other practices, you need to say them out loud with your own voice so that they hear you. Different practices, different ways, but we are all reaching the same goal. And then after you have said your names, then ugogo umkhulu will then hit the bag, or will then shake the bag on the ground, and then it will, you know, the bag will be shaken, and it's either they will start reciting their clan names just as they are busy with the bag, Or they will shake the bag, throw the bones, and then start reciting their clan names and inviting also their spirits and introducing you to their ancestors to say, this is who is here today, isibongo sakho, your surnames as you have said them. And then we invite your ancestors to also come through in your consultation. And with that being done, there's also many different things. Okay, the bones can be thrown on a grass mat, or the bones can be thrown on the skin of an animal. Mostly you would find that it is a goat skin that we use, and the goat skin would have then come from one of the ceremonies that Ugogo Umkulu had during their training processes. And then once the bones are thrown, Ugogo Umkulu will either use impepho to burn to invite the spirits. This is before, after, or even during the consultation. You will find that others use snuff to pour on top of the bones, or you will find that even water is included. Different ndumbas, like I say, different practices. But at the end of the day, we are inviting spirit to come through and give guidance in the divination or in the consultation that is being carried out. Once Ugogo has thrown the bones, then the reading starts. You will not really understand or see what is happening, but Ugogo will be pointing to say, this is what the bones are telling me. Inkolo ishonje or masapo aha or ditaola how had to dwell in nabadimu bari. And that is where the divination and the consultation then takes place. And that is where your spiritual disease are then diagnosed, or where they are then identified. And in most ndumbas, when you come, you will be guided to say, when Ugogo Umkulu is talking, you need to say siyavuma, 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 and this means that I agree with what you are diagnosing. And then after the reading, that is when then maybe there will be that discussion to say, this is what has been diagnosed from the bones, and this is a way forward in terms of treatment. But again, in the very same inklolo, we then talk about pendula inklolo, or sort of like re-throwing the bones again. And this is where then the treatment is given, because Ugogo and Umkulu, once they read the bones and identify your problems, they will then need to also go back and ask abantu abadala ukuthi, how do I assist this person? This is because that the diagnosis has been done through the inkolo ditaola, and therefore the treatment will also be coming from inkolo. And this is where in ndumbas you will find that Gogo will pick up the bones and throw them again. But like I said, different ndumbas, different practices, and sometimes even different clauses, different practices. Other clauses will identify the problem and the solution in the same breath, but others will then identify all the problems and want you to come back and ask for solutions. Then when you come to the treatment, it will then depend on the urgency of your diagnosis, whether you will start the treatment immediately, Gogo, or you will be told you can go and come back for treatment later. But basically that is inkolo, that is ditaola. Ditaola, also referred to as the floor x-ray, because we are throwing the bones down and we are actually looking into what is happening with you spiritually, that is now causing all the physical ailments and the life problems. If you have found the information in this video insightful, do not forget to hit the like button. Do not forget to subscribe. Click the subscribe button below. In this classroom, a lesson learned is a lesson shared. So do not be afraid to click that share button. If you have not followed me on any other social media platform, please click and look at the description below. There are links to my Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok pages, and you can just go and check out the classroom there, because there's lots of content on the classroom in itself. I do my lives on TikTok, and I also do a lot of dream interpretation on TikTok, so go check it out, and do not forget to follow when you get there. The other thing that I would like to do at the end of each lesson is just to do a recap. So let me do a recap of what we have learned today. Today we talked about ditaola, and as defined by Gogo Noma, I always say that it is the badimu given tools that help me to diagnose and plan treatment for patients that come with spiritual disease that are now manifesting as physical ailments or life problems. And inhlolo is kept in isikhwama or a bag that we then find Ditaola inside. And most of the time we will find that this isikhwama is also referred to as the gift in itself. Hence we will be referring to umnikazi wesikhwama, the gift bearer. This is the ugogo umkhulu that you'll be dreaming about, or that will be identified as the one who's gifting you. In different isikhwamas we will find different inhlolos or Ditaola tse fapaneng. It can be dominoes, it can be bones from different animals, it can be your dice, money, anything that your ancestors would choose, even your crystal stones, anything that your ancestors will choose for you to use as divination tools, that is what you will then put as skhwameni sakho. So different skhwamas for different gogos. Like I said, the skhwamas can be obtained in different ways. One, it can be in lapha uthwase khona as an institute, you're given the same skhwama, or it could be that you've been collecting without even knowing the bones or Ditaola tsa hao, or it could be that it's passed from generation to generation in your family because it's kept and preserved if you are from a background where culture has always been preserved, regardless of everything that we've been through as a nation. That is Ditaola. Ditaola, you come in and Ndumbeni and Ugogo will then throw the bones in order to help identify what you are coming with as a problem. And then through that diagnosing process, a very same process again is followed to give a treatment plan for you. Inhlolo kahle kahle, when we talk about ukuhlola, this is one of the biggest tools that we use, especially if we are talking about bone throwing. There are many different ways in which we can do a spiritual consultation, but today I was just concentrating on the Ditaola. As other people use mirrors, when you go to abantu abathandazayo, aba prophet, you will find that we use the Bible, we use water, or we use candles. A lot of methods can be used. So the Ditaola is that tool that we are using to help reach the gap between the physical and the spiritual realm. And this is where you will get your diagnosis and your treatment spiritually. I hope that you have found this lesson insightful. There will definitely be another lesson coming where we will maybe talk more about Ditaola tsa ba profeta, but today I was more talking about Ditaola tsa masangoma, divination bones for a sangoma. I am Gogo Noma and this is Learning with Noma. Thank you so much for joining me in this lesson. Remember, in this classroom, we are learning together, we are growing together, changing our lives one lesson at a time. Until next time, Tavos. Lesedi.